Welcome to an example of producer surplus. We're given that x is a number of items, the demand function is d of x, and the supply function is s of x. Number one, we want to determine the equilibrium point, and then number two, determine the producer surplus at the equilibrium point. Let's begin by reviewing producer surplus. The benefit a producer receives when supplying more units at a price that is higher than a price at which fewer units would be supplied is called producer surplus. One way to think of this was if you were selling a used car and you said you wanted to sell the car for $2,500, but you listed the car at $3,000 and it actually sold at $3,000, the extra $500 that you received unexpectedly could be considered producer surplus. If we take a look at the supply function on the coordinate plane as we see here, where we have quantity on the horizontal axis and price on the vertical axis, if the point Q comma P is the equilibrium point, this area here would represent the producer surplus. Notice how there are producers that would have been willing to supply the product at a lower price, but it's actually selling at a higher price, therefore the extra money received is producer surplus. Producer surplus is equal to Q times P minus the integral of S of X from 0 to Q. So we're finding the area of this rectangle here, which is Q times P, and then subtracting the area under the supply function from 0 to Q, leaving us with producer surplus. So going back to our example, the first step is to find the equilibrium point, which is the point where the supply and demand are equal to each other. So if we want to determine where D of X equals S of X, that would occur when 400 minus 0.5x equals 0.3x. So to solve for x, let's add 0.5x to both sides, giving us 400 equals 0.8x. Dividing both sides by 0.8, we have x equals 400 divided by 0.8, or 500. So 500 would be the quantity of the equilibrium point, but we still have to find the equilibrium price. To do this, we can use either the supply function or the demand function. Let's go ahead and use the supply function. S of 500 would be equal to 0.3 times 500, or 150. So the equilibrium point is 500 comma 150, where again 500 is the equilibrium quantity and 150 is the equilibrium price. Now before we find the producer surplus, let's look at the graph of d of x and s of x on the coordinate plane. The red line is a demand function d of x and the blue line is a supply function s of x. We just found this point here, the point of equilibrium, where the quantity is 500 and the price is $150. And this green area here is the producer surplus. So we'll find the area of this rectangle and subtract the area under the supply function over the interval from 0 to 500. So the producer surplus is going to be equal to Q times P, which is 500 times 150, minus the integral of S of X, or 0.3x, from 0 to 500. 500 times 150 is 75,000. So we have 75,000. And then minus the def integral. To evaluate this, we'll first find the antiderivative of 0.3x, which would be 0.3 times x squared divided by 2. Well, 0.3 times 1 half or divided by 2 would be 0.15. So now we'll evaluate this at 500 and then 0 and then find the difference. So when x is 500, we'll have 0.15 times 500 squared minus when x is 0, of course this is 0. So this is going to be 75,000 minus This comes out to 37,500. And this difference is 37,500, which means the producer surplus is $37,500. I hope you found this helpful.